My name is Régine Debatty and I'm a blogger. I also work as an art critic and as a curator, and my blog is called We Make Money, Not Art.
You were presenting yesterday a paper.
Not a paper.
Can you please describe what was it about?
So it was about interventions about like the way artists and activists, and they might have been the work of designers as well, but mostly artists and activism, the way they are reacting to and commenting on the fact that we live in a very controlled and society, and then the fact that there's a lot of surveillance in the streets of the big city. So it was mostly like in 15 minutes, I try to put as many artist projects as possible.
Society of control.
Yeah, society of control. It sounds very, French philosopher, but because I was, I reacted to the fact that the news that really surprised me the most recently was the mass surveillance program, the NSA, and also actually the fact that the creator of the Silk Road has been arrested. I'm not a customer of the Silk Road, but I cannot, I'm really wondering what's going to happen to him, because he's really, really smart, and I guess it's only the start of really, really big problems for him. So that's why I chose this topic.
How do you see that it relates to the general topic of this symposium?
I don't know. When I read the PDF, the short introduction to transitory art, it seems to deal a lot with non-conventional and non-institutional creative intervention, many of them in public space, some using technology really not mainstream, and of people, of artists being really involved in social issues. So I thought, I'm going to try and present this, and maybe people will say that's absolutely not transitory, or maybe I'll be right and it's transitory. So it was just, it was my own take on transitory, and hopefully I got the concept.
How do you understand this term?
I understand as something like the kind of intervention that is reacting to society and the kind of problems and issues we are living. So it's a kind of art intervention, but not disconnected from society. So it's not necessarily the kind of lovely paintings and sculpture and digital art you can see in museums and some art galleries, in some, not in all. I think it's a kind of art intervention that really engage with the time we are living in.